before starting, let me show some pictures to you. Students, when you observe these pictures, tell me which is the first word which comes in your mind after observing all of these. Yes, you are very correct. The word which comes in your mind is secret agent or spy. Yes, students, you are very correct. Today, we are going to deal something about this. But before this, just tell me, have you ever seen a spy movie or read a spy story? What is it? Do you like it? Why? What is a spy like? What is your general impression of a spy? You all might have created a different impression of a spy. Students, I think you are a little bit clear that today our chapter is somewhat dealing with spy or secret agent. Yes, dear students, today I have taken a prose from the textbook Footprints Without Feet, that is Prose 3, The Midnight Visitor. The Midnight Visitor is written by Robert Arthur. So, let's know something about the author. Robert J. Arthur was a writer of speculative fiction known for his work with the Mysterious Traveler radio series and for writing The Three Investigators, a series of young adult novels. Arthur was honored twice by the Mystery Writers of America with an Edgar Award for Best Radio Drama. He also wrote scripts for television such as The Twilight Zone and Alfred Hitchcock's TV show, Alfred Hitchcock's Presents. Now, let me give you the basic introduction of the story. Ozzable, a secret agent, is expecting to get a very important report. Another secret agent, Max, threatens him with a pistol, demanding the report. Does Ozzable outwit him? Students, let us read and find out how is Ozzable different from other secret agents. Who is Fowler and what is his first authentic thrill of the day? Now, let me introduce you with the three characters in the story. The first one is Ozzable, a secret agent. The second character is Max, another secret agent, or you can say a rival agent of Ozzable. The third character in the story is Fowler, who is a young writer. So, now, let's get into the story. Ozzable did not fit any description of a secret agent Fowler had ever read. So, here the author says that Fowler, who was a young writer, he had learned and read about secret agents. Okay, so he had made a certain visualization and description about the secret agents. So when he met Ozzable, the secret agent, so he found that Ozzable, the secret agent, did not fit in the description of a secret agent what he had read about. Following him down the musty corridor of the gloomy French hotel where Ozzable had a room, Fowler felt let down. It was a small room on the sixth and top floor and scarcely a setting for a romantic adventure. So, here the word musty means having damp smell, okay? And the word gloomy means poorly lit, okay? Or dark with low lights, okay? So here in this paragraph, the author says that Fowler was following Audible. Okay, he was walking along with Audible down the musty corridors. Musty means damp smelt corridors of that gloomy French hotel. Gloomy means that poorly lit French hotel where Audible had a room. Okay, so while this, Fowler felt let down means he felt disappointed, since it was a small room on the sixth and top floor, and the room scarcely, means just not well enough, had a setting for having a romantic adventure. Now here romantic adventure means to have unrealistic experiences. So Fowler felt disappointed after seeing all these. Next, here the author says that Audible was for one thing fat, very fat, and then there was his accent. Though he spoke French and German passably, he had never altogether lost the American accent he had brought to Paris from Boston 20 years ago. So here accent means a different way of pronouncing a language, okay? And passably means somehow well enough, okay? Not that good, but yes, tolerably well enough. So in this paragraph, the author has explained that Audible was very fat. So this reason also disappointed the young writer Fowler. And then the second was his accent. Okay, so though this Audible, he spoke French and German somehow well enough, but he had altogether never lost the American accent also while speaking French and German, which he has brought to Paris from Boston 20 years ago. So while speaking French and German, always the accent of the America was also heard or felt in his language. Next, here in this paragraph it is written that Audible, he says to Fowler, "You are disappointed," Audible said wheezily over his shoulder. Now here wheezily means breathing heavily or noisily. So Audible spoke this to young Fowler and said him that he was disappointed. Means Fowler was disappointed. "You were told," the author says that Audible tells Fowler that although he was told that he was going to meet a secret agent, a spy who had been dealing with danger and crime scenes and drugs, but Fowler was disappointed. Then he says, "Instead, you have spent a dull evening in a French music hall with a sloppy fat man who, instead of having messages slipped into his hand by dark-eyed beauties, gets only a prosaic telephone call making an appointment in his room. You have been bored." So, through this paragraph, we understand that now Audible, he continues speaking with Fowler, and he says that Fowler had to spend the evening in a music hall with an old, poorly dressed, extremely fat man. Okay, he says here sloppy fat man, means sloppy here means carelessly dressed man. Okay, and he says that uses the traditional methods for making the information travel rather than beauty is delivering him. And then at last he exclaimed that Fowler was bored. Okay, he says you have been bored. So he exclaimed that Fowler was bored with him. The fat man chuckled to himself as he unlocked the door of his room and stood aside to let his frustrated guest enter. Okay, so here, as soon as he opened the door of his room, means as soon as Audible, the secret agent, he opened the door of his room, he gave way to Fowler. He gave way to the frustrated guest. Here refers to the young Fowler. So Audible, he stood aside to the door and then he let the young Fowler to enter the room. Now here further he says, "You are disillusioned," Audible told him, But take cheer, my young friend. Presently, you will see a paper, a quite important paper, for which several men and women have risked their lives. Come to me. Someday, soon that paper will affect the course of history. In that thought is drama, is there not? Here in this paragraph, it says that Ausable, he said to young Fowler that he was disappointed. But then he adds that he should not be disappointed, he should be happy. He says, but take cheer, that means be happy. And he addressed him as young friend. And then he added and informed him that presently, means at the current time, he will be able to see a paper which was very important. And it was important for everyone. And for this paper, several men and women have even risked their lives come to him for getting this paper. Also, he said that someday soon, this paper may well affect the course of history. And then at last he questioned to the young Fowler that is that thought not a drama? So this he questioned to the young Fowler. Next, as he spoke, Ausable closed the door behind him. Then he switched on the light. And as the light came on, Fowler had his first authentic thrill of the day. So now here, as Ausable was speaking, he just closed the door behind him, and then as he was just about to switch on the light, so as he switched on the light and the light came in the room, Fowler had experienced his first authentic thrill of the day. Now here the word authentic means very genuine, okay, the real thrill of the day. And what was that real thrill of the day which Fowler had experienced just then? Let's read it. Understand. For halfway across the room, a small automatic pistol in his hand, stood a man. So what was that authentic thrill? There, just a distance away in the room, there was a man who was standing with a small automatic pistol in his hand. Ausable blinked a few times. Max, he wheezed, you gave me quite a start. I thought you were in Berlin. What are you doing here in my room? So, when Ausable saw a man standing in his room, he blinked a few times. Means he got surprised and he blinked few times. And then he recognized the man as Max. And so, he addressed him saying, Max. And he said this wheezily. Wheezily means breathing heavily. Okay, and noisily. And then he said, you gave me quite a start, means he gave him a surprise. And then he also tells him that he thought that he was in Berlin, means Ausable thought that Max was in Berlin. And so he questioned him that what are you doing now in my room? If you were supposed to be in Berlin, so what are you doing in my room at this time? Let's read next. Max was slender, a little less than tall, with features that suggested slightly the crafty, pointed countenance of a fox. There was about him, aside from the gun, nothing especially menacing. So now in this paragraph, the author has described the appearance of Max. So the author says that Max was slender. Slender means very thin. And he was little less than tall, means he was not very tall, but yes, medium sized height he was having. With features that suggested slightly the crafty pointed countenance. Now countenance means here the facial expression. So the author says that his face was somewhat like the face of the fox, and there was nothing special about him, or he did not seem to be harmful for anyone. He was just looking very harmless person. Just one thing which was little different was that he was having the gun, okay, and nothing specially menacing, nothing threatening about Max, except that he was having a gun in his hand. So overall, the author has described that Max was very thin, a bit short, and his face looked like that of a fox. And also, he added that he seemed very harmless, except that the gun he was holding in his hand. Then, the report, he murmured, the report that is being brought to you tonight concerning some new missiles. I thought I would take it from you. It will be safer in my hand than in yours. The author says that Max said that he wanted the report about the missiles for which Ozzable had been waiting, okay, as he thought that he would be able to keep it more safely. Okay, Max thought that he will keep the documents more safely. And this sentence was just said in a fun way to create humor, as only idea was that Max, he wanted to keep the reports for his own benefits. Now let's see next paragraph. Here in the next paragraph, it is said that Ozzable moved to an armchair and sat down heavily. I am going to raise the devil with the management this time, and you can bet on it, he said grimly. This is the second time in a month that somebody has got into my room through that noisance of a balcony. So the author has described the immediate reaction which came from Ozzable, okay, after listening to Max. So he now here the author says that Ozzable, after listening to Max, that he had come here to get the papers, he sat down on the chair and he started speaking that he would definitely have a fight with the management of the hotel, as this was the second time that someone had climbed up from the balcony of the room and entered his room. Okay, and he said all this grimly, means very seriously. Okay, he just went there to the armchair and sat down heavily, and then he started saying seriously that he was going to raise the devil, means he is going to complain to the management this time, that this is the second time that somebody had got into his room without permission through that balcony. Now, in the next paragraph, it is written that Fowler's eyes went to the single window of the room. It was an ordinary window against which now the night was pressing blackly. So here the author says that after listening to Ozzable, the young Fowler, okay, who was there standing and seeing all this drama, he just after listening to Ozzable speaking about balcony, he saw just a single window of the room. His eyes went towards the single window which was there in the room, and after observing that window, he felt that it was just a very ordinary window, and against which he could see the night pressing blackly, means it was pretty much darker outside of the window, means it was a night time. Next, after Ozzable said all those things and that he will be complaining to the management, the response which came from this Max was that he questioned. Balcony? Max said with a rising inflection. No, a pass key. I did not know about the balcony. It might have saved me some trouble had I known. So now here Max, he gave reply to Ozzable, and then he questioned him that balcony, and he said this with little change in his tone, okay, and then he informed Ozzable that no, he had used only a pass key. He not come using any balcony, and also he informed that he even did not know about any balcony, and he said that if he would have known about balcony, then he would have surely come through that balcony, because it would have gave him less trouble to enter this room. It would have made him easier for him to enter this room. Let's see further. Now here the author says that it's not my balcony, Ozzable said with extreme irritation. It belongs to the next apartment. He glanced explanatorily at Fowler. You see, he said, this room used to be a part of a large unit, and the next room through that door there used to be the living room. It had the balcony which extends under my window now. You can get onto it from the empty room two doors down. And somebody did last month. The management promised to block it off, but they haven't. Here the word this glanced means to take a brief or hurried look, okay? And the word explanatorily means trying to explain something, okay? So here the author has described that Audible continued speaking, okay? And Audible said that it was not his balcony through which people had tried coming in, but was of the next apartment. He then started explaining things to Fowler, that his room used to be a part of large unit, and then a room next to his room used to be a living room. And then he said that it had the balcony that came till the window of his room. Then he said that to climb up to his room, one needed to go to the empty room, which was two rooms away from his room, and climb up the balcony. Then he said that somebody did climb up the balcony last month as well. And also he told Fowler that the management had told him, Miss told to Audible, that they would surely get it blocked, but the management still hadn't done anything so far. So Max glanced at Fowler, who was standing stiffly not far from Audible, and waved the gun with a commanding gesture. Please sit down, he said. We have a wait of half an hour, I think. Here, the word stiffly means standing in a manner which is not relaxed or friendly. Okay? And gesture means a movement of a part of a body. It can be hand or head to express any idea or any meaning. So here in this paragraph, this Max, he looked at Fowler, who was standing near Audible. Okay, as you can see in the picture, this is Fowler who is standing next to this Audible, the secret agent, and this is Max who has pointed out the gun towards them. So this Max, after listening to Audible, he had a glance, he looked at Fowler and who was standing near Audible, and then asked Fowler to sit down, okay? And he commanded him to sit down, as there was still half an hour left for the report to reach to Audible. Further, now here Audible, he's speaking now to Max. He says, 31 minutes, Audible said moodily. The appointment was for 12:30. I wish I knew how you learned about the report, Max. Here, now Audible, he joked that it was not 30 minutes, but 31 minutes that were left for the report to reach here. So, and he added that report was supposed to come in around 12:30 at night. And also, he informed to Max that he wished, he wanted to know that how Max had come to know about the report coming in. Next, the little spy smiled heavily, and we wish we knew how your people got the report, but no harm has been done. I will get it back tonight. What is that? Who is at the door? So here in this paragraph, the author says that after listening to Audible, Max, he smiled wickedly. Okay, heavily means here, not in a morally correct way. And then he said that he also wished to know, means he also wanted to know that how Audible and his team had got the report. He added that nothing had happened to the report because, no harm has been done to the report because now he is there and he will take it from Audible straight to his team members. And then all of a sudden, he heard a sudden knock at the door. Okay, so he questioned Audible, what is that? Who is at the door? Fowler jumped at the sudden knocking at the door. Audible just smiled. That will be the police, he said. I thought that such an important paper as the one we are waiting for should have a little extra protection. I told them to check on me to make sure everything was all right. So he says that after listening to the sudden knocking at the door, as you can see, somebody was knocking at the door. This Fowler, okay, the young writer who was standing next to Ozubel, he got panicked and he jumped at the sudden knocking of the door. And Ozubel, on the other hand, he was very relaxed and he just smiled, okay? And then he informed or said that it may be the police who was at the door, because he had asked them to check on him after some time, as he thought that the report he was about to receive was important and definitely it required extra attention. So he had asked the police to check on him after every some time to make sure that everything was all right. So after listening to Ozubel that police was at the door, Max bit his lip nervously. The knocking was repeated. So Max was now a little nervous, as you can see in the picture what biting the lips means. So Max was a little nervous and the knocking at the door was repeated. "What will you do now, Max?" Ozubel asked. "If I do not answer the door, they will enter anyway. The door is unlocked and they will not hesitate to shoot." So now in this paragraph, Ozubel is questioning to Max that now what he will do. And also he added that if he will not answer the door, means if he will not open the door, then also they will enter the room anyhow, because he told that the door was unlocked. And so the police, they will not hesitate to come inside the room and to shoot Max. So Max's face was black with anger as he backed swiftly towards the window. He swung a leg over the sill. "Send them away," he warned. "I will wait on the balcony. Send them away or I will shoot and take my chances." So now here Max's face was black with anger means Max became very much angry at the situation, and he backed swiftly means quickly he moved backward towards the window. And then he swung a leg means he put his leg over the sill. Sill is nothing but a platform beneath the window. Okay. So he swung his leg over the sill, and he, while doing this, he was just commanding or just telling to Ozubel to send the police away. He was warning Ozubel that send them away, send the police away, and he will be waiting on the balcony, he said. And he again warned Ozubel that you send the police away or he will shoot and take all his chances. The knocking at the door became louder and a voice was raised. "Mr. Ozubel, Mr. Ozubel." So now the knocking at the door was still becoming more and more louder, and then voice was also raised and somebody at the door was calling out Ozubel's name. Further, the author says that keeping his body twisted so that his gun still covered the fat man and his guest, the man at the window grasped the frame with his free hand to support himself. Then he swung his other leg up and over the window sill. This paragraph says that Max was now sitting on the window sill and was facing inside so that his gun could still be pointed towards Mr. Ozubel and his guest Fowler. Okay. And Max then held the window sill and then he sat at the sill with both the legs outside. The doorknob turned. Swiftly, Max pushed it with his left hand to free himself from the sill and dropped to the balcony. And then, as he dropped, he screamed once, shrilly. Here, the word shrilly means in high pitch sound. Okay? So now, the doorknob turned. So that means the door was now opened and Max thought that the police would be coming in. So he jumped from the sill to fall on the balcony. And when he fell, a loud and shrill scream was heard. Now next, let's see what happened. The door opened and a waiter stood there with a tray, a bottle and two glasses. "Here is the drink you ordered for when you returned," he said, and set the tray on the table, deftly uncorked the bottle and left the room. Here the word deftly means cleverly, and uncorked means to open the bottle, okay, to open out the cork from the bottle. So in this paragraph, the author says that when the door opened, a waiter stood at the door with a tray, a bottle of wine and two glasses. He came in and kept everything on the table very skillfully, very cleverly, means deftly, and said that it was the bottle that Ozubel had ordered for earlier. He opened the cork of the bottle skillfully and then left from the room. Now, after the waiter left from the room, now the young fowler, he said he was little puzzled. White-faced fowler stared after him, but he stammered the police. Now here, Fowler was little puzzled. He did not understand what had happened, and he stammered. Stammered means he spoke with little pauses, and he said that the police, means he was confused. He thought that police will get inside, but somebody else came. So he was little confused that how come the waiter came when the police was supposed to come inside. For which Ozubel replied, "There were no police." Ozubel sighed, "Only Henry, whom I was expecting." So the question which this young fowler had in his mind, for this question now Ozubel replied that there was no police, and that he knew that it was Henry the waiter, and he was expecting him only. Then the young fowler, he continued, "But won't that man out on the balcony?" Fowler began. So he was still confused that agent Max would be waiting at the balcony. Okay, so he questioned to Ozubel that whether that man out on the balcony. "No," said Ozubel, "he won't return. You see, my young friend, there is no balcony." So for which this Ozubel replied that he would never come back, means that Max, the rival agent, would never come back, as there was no balcony, and that Max had fallen on the ground from the top floor of the building. So this is how we at the end of the chapter. So students, now let's see the theme of the story. The theme of the story is, one should not judge a person by merely his appearance. Ozubel is fat and lazy, but he is the most intelligent of all in the story. So we should never judge any person by just seeing their appearance. Okay, now as we have seen in the story that Ozubel was not physically well suitable in the concept of secret agents, or in the way the secret agents are always described as, but still he was sharp minded and he was the most intelligent of all in the story. Now let's see the message given by Robert Arthur through this story. So Robert Arthur has given a very wonderful message in the story, and he says that we should know how to react in any situation. He says, in any situation, we should not panic. Instead, we should take a step and face the situation with great presence of mind. So, dear students, you should always have that courage and that presence of mind to deal with any type of difficult situations in your life. Thangrins, I hope you have understood this lesson. So, dear children, keep swatting and keep thriving. If you have any questions or queries, please feel free to ask in the comment section. So, thank you once again.